Emmit Stussy.
He's the parking lot king of Minnesota, and he's obviously quite well off.
I got a car from the Oak Bridge lot.
Right. Why do we buy that one again?
He's a faithful man, he's a decent father, but you can see the sort of businessman side of Emmit, which is not nearly so pleasant.
Irv, stop screwing around.
It seems to be more of a personal, internal battle between these two brothers.
Ray, sometimes when you do a piss test, they... why not just put on both the other pair? Well, it happens a lot. Basically, this is now my only non-micturated footwear.
Cy is Emmit Stussy's right-hand man. Cy is loyal to Emmit. He sees Ray as a burden.
In a way, Cy has become Emmett's brother. He's got a great deal of power in their empire. And Cy rubs his nose in that, I think.
Your brother's a loser.
He's not a loser.
Well, he's doing a pretty good imitation.
Cy and Emmit run a prosperous business. He's been giving things to Ray for many years. I think Cy would like to encourage Emmit to draw the line with Ray.
Feminine hygiene deployed as a weapon?
I don't know what you... You want to watch your tone when you talk to me, errand boy.
I'm always looking for places to use actors who've worked with Joel and Ethan before, just because I know they fit into that world.
Michael Stuhlbarg is a completely committed actor and puts himself through the ringer to get to his performance.
Ewan, he's doing an amazing job, and what a huge challenge for him. There's a lot of laughter.
Like I say, we got it. I just need to know where to send the check.
It's the Coens kind of absurdity and tragic comedy or comic tragedy.
The scripts are very much written in that Fargo-esque way. The humor comes out of that too, I think.
You think maybe it's... I don't even want to say it out loud.
Slave girls?
What? No. I was going to say drugs. You think it's slave girls?
The balance of the absurd and the wicked. There's a lot going on underneath the sort of kind exterior that they try to put forth.